So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In this class guys, we'll be talking about the PIB news from 18th to 20th of June 2023 and I hope the revisions are going well. Okay, ab main preparations ki baat nahi karta hu because I believe the preparations are done now. You guys just should just focus on the revisions now. And yesterday the session could not happen due to certain reasons. So isliye session aaj ho raha hai. The timings will remain same only, but आज के लिए मैं थर्सडे को सेशन कंडक्ट कर रहा हूँ बिकॉज कल नहीं हो पाया था बट आई के नॉट डू कि मैं वेडनेसडे की क्लास को स्किप ही कर दूँ, वो नहीं हो सकता बिकॉज दिस इज द एग्जाम टाइम दैट इज गोइंग ऑन. सो आई जस्ट के नॉट डू कि एक दिन में बहुत सारा आपको पढ़ा दूँ फ्राइडे को. ठीक है, तो इसलिए आज क्लास है और कल क्लास है, फिर उसके बाद नेक्स्ट टाइम से मंडे वेडनेसडे फ्राइडे जैसा चल रहा था वैसे ही चलेगा. देर इज नो चेंज इन द टाइमिंग्स एंड द शेड्यूल्स, राइट? सो लेट्स बिगिन विद टुडेज क्लास गाइज. एंड या क्योंकि कल क्लास नहीं हुई तो इसलिए आज की क्लास थोड़ी सी लंबी होगी. ठीक है, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ नेशनल वर्किंग प्लान कोड 2023 रिसेंटली रिलीज बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट फॉरेस्ट एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ वर्ल्ड डे टू कंबैट डिजर्टिफिकेशन एंड ड्रॉट. सो नाउ यू हैव टू टेल मी दिस थिंग दैट व्हेन वाज दिस डे ऑब्जर्व, कौन से दिन पे ये डे ऑब्जर्व किया जाता है एवरी डे एवरी ईयर. सो यू नीड टू टेल मी दैट. So let's talk about National Working Plan Code 2023, which has been launched by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change on this day, that is World Day to Combat Desertification and Drought. Now, what will this National Working Plan Code 2023 will do? With what objective this code has been launched? Remember, the code will help the states in scientific management of the forest, right? It has been launched for scientific management of forest and evolving new approaches. This working plan code will guide as a guiding principle for state forest departments. It will act as a guiding principle for state forest departments in preparation for working plan for different forest divisions within the states and overall across the country. All right, it deals in detail with essentials of forest management, preparing, incorporating principles of sustainable management of forest. Not only just the management of forest, but it talks about the sustainable management of forest. Everything we are doing today is in terms of sustainable development only, because sirf aaj ki cheezon ka dhyan rakhne se kuch bhi nahi chalne wala. If we want to save this world, we need to focus on the sustainable management of everything, right? So on that line, this National Working Plan Code 2023 has been codified by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. It has also for the first time prescribed the state forest department to engage in continuous data collection, and its updation is a centralized database so that the government, the agencies, the organization will remain updated regarding any kind of deforestation, any kind of forest degradation. Theek hai, to wahan pe kaam kiya ja sakega. And this Indian forest management standard, it is a part of this code, and this standard takes into account the diverse forest ecosystem in our country to bring in uniformity in the management of the forest, right? It will also facilitate the state forest departments to measure the effectiveness of the management practices, right? It will help the state forest department in what? In measuring the effectiveness of the management practices against the prescriptions of the working plans. Jo working plans hai, wo theek tarike se chal rahe hai ya nahi chal rahe hai, that will be measured through this Indian forest management standard. Right, and these are certain standards, and these standards have to be followed by the state governments while managing the forest, right? So that is all about this news. And what is the correct answer? What is the purpose? The purpose has been asked. The correct answer will be option C, scientific management of forest. Let's talk about question number 2. Identify incorrect statement about Vaibhav fellowship program. And here Vaibhav stands for Vaishvik Bhartiya Vaigyanik. Vaishvik Bhartiya Vaigyanik, in English it means global Indian scientist, right? Global Indian scientist. So let's talk about Vaibhav fellowship program. It has been launched by the Ministry of Science and Technology, headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh. The Vaibhav fellowship program has not been launched by the Ministry of Education. First of all, please do not confuse here between the Ministry of Science and Technology and Education. Okay, it is the Ministry of Science and Technology which has launched it. Now these fellowship program have been launched to connect Indian STEM diaspora with Indian higher educational institution. What is STEM here? There is double M here. So सिंगल एम तो आपको पता ही होगा, साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स एंड दिस लास्ट एम इज फॉर द मेडिसिन, दिस लास्ट एम इज फॉर मेडिसिन. सो व्हाट विल दिस फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम डू? दिस फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम विल कनेक्ट द स्टेम साइंटिस्ट फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द कंट्री विच आर ऑफ इंडियन ओरिजिन और एनआरआईज और ओसीआई, एंड दीज साइंटिस्ट विल बी कनेक्टेड टू द इंडियन हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर रिसर्च. राइट, दैट इज द होल आइडिया ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट इट. द ऑब्जेक्टिव आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू. एलिजिबिलिटी क्या है इसकी? द पर्सन द रिसर्चर विल बी अ साइंटिस्ट और टेक्नोलॉजिस्ट ऑफ इंडियन ओरिजिन, कैन बी आइदर एनआरआई ओसीआई और पीआईओ, हु आर एंगेज्ड इन रिसर्च एक्टिविटीज इन द रिस्पेक्टिव कंट्रीज. राइट, नाउ इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी विल बी द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी विच ऑफ कोर्स वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. 75 सिलेक्टेड वेब ऑफ फेलोज. हाउ मेनी फेलोज विल बी सिलेक्टेड? 75. Do remember the number, it is important. 75 selected Weber fellows will be invited to work in 18 identified knowledge areas. And some of the knowledge areas are these. You don't have to remember all the 18 knowledge areas. That is not required for the exam. Just remember that there are 18 identified knowledge areas on which the research will be done. Right? They will identify the Indian institution. The researchers will themselves identify the Indian institutions for collaboration and spend up to 2 months in a year for a maximum of 3 years in that particular Indian educational higher educational institution. ठीक है, minimum साल में 2 महीने for a period of 3 years. And पैसा कितना मिलेगा fellowship में? So fellowship grant of 4 lakh rupees per month, international and domestic travel, accommodation and contingency, everything will be provided. ठीक है, 4 lakh per month. Now, 4 लाख पर मंथ जो मिलेगा वो उस पीरियड के लिए मिलेगा, द पीरियड फॉर विच दे आर रिजाइडिंग इन द कंट्री इन दैट हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन. ठीक है जी, 3 सालों के लिए लगातार 4 लाख पर मंथ देंगे तो भाई बहुत ज्यादा हो जाएगा. राइट, ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट इट. लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन. पहला ही स्टेटमेंट बिल्कुल और सरासर गलत है, झूठ है. इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, विच मीन्स द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी ऑप्शन ए. ऑलराइट, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 पे आते. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. नीति आयोग एंड यूनाइटेड नेशंस इन इंडिया हैव साइंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया यूनाइटेड नेशन सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट कोऑपरेशन फ्रेमवर्क 2023-27. इट हैज बीन बिल्ट ऑन 4 strategic पिलर्स डिराइव फ्रॉम 2030 एजेंडा, पीपल, पार्टिसिपेशन, प्रोस्पेरिटी एंड प्लानेट. These 4 interlinked pillars have which of the following outcome areas? कौन कौन से आउटकम एरियाज हैं आपको वो बताने हैं. ठीक है जी, इन चारों पिलर्स के कौन कौन से आउटकम एरियाज है, बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज है. बिफोर दिस द फ्रेमवर्क वॉज फॉर द पीरियड ऑफ 2018-22, एंड नाउ वी हैव साइंड अ न्यू एग्रीमेंट विद यूनाइटेड नेशंस इन इंडिया विद न्यू फ्रेमवर्क पीरियड दैट इज 2023-27. नाउ व्हाट दिस फ्रेमवर्क एक्चुअली इज, ये फ्रेमवर्क है क्या उसकी बात करते हैं. सो द न्यूज इज दिस ओनली, नीति आयोग एंड यूनाइटेड नेशंस इन इंडिया हैव साइंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया यूनाइटेड नेशंस सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट कोऑपरेशन फ्रेमवर्क फॉर द पीरियड ऑफ 2023-27. दिस फ्रेमवर्क हैज बीन डेजिग्नेटेड एज द प्रिंसिपल प्लानिंग डॉक्यूमेंट और प्रिंसिपल प्लानिंग फ्रेमवर्क एंड इंप्लीमेंटेशन इंस्ट्रूमेंट फॉर यूनाइटेड नेशन डेवलपमेंट सिस्टम. ठीक है, जो भी यूनाइटेड नेशन का डेवलपमेंट सिस्टम है एट द कंट्री लेवल that works on the basis of this framework, right? And it helps in deriving program priorities of UN entities working in that country. For example, let's say agar ILO nahi, koi aur UN organization le lo, ECOSOC le lo, ya UNESCO le lo. If UNESCO's branch is working in India, right? To wo branch इस 4 साल के पीरियड में क्या क्या काम करेगी, कैसे कैसे आगे बढ़ेगी, ऑल ऑफ दीज इंफॉर्मेशन आर प्रोवाइडेड इन दिस फ्रेमवर्क. राइट, नाउ इट रिप्रेजेंट्स यूनाइटेड नेशन डेवलपमेंट सिस्टम कलेक्टिव ऑफर टू दैट पर्टिकुलर कंट्री, हेयर इन दिस केस इंडिया, इन लाइन विद द नेशनल विजन फॉर द डेवलपमेंट फॉर अचीवमेंट ऑफ सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल फॉर जेंडर इक्वालिटी फॉर हेल्थ इश्यूज फॉर एजुकेशन एवरीथिंग रिलेटेड टू द डेवलपमेंट एंड ग्रोथ ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर नेशन. राइट, its formulation was led by Niti Aayog on behalf of the government of India with participation from the various ministries and organizations. एंड इट हैज बीन बिल्ट ऑन फोर स्ट्रेटेजिक पिलर्स, जो कि मैंने आपको पहले बता दिया, क्वेश्चन में मेंशन था, पीपल, प्रोस्पेरिटी, प्लैनेट एंड पार्टिसिपेशन. व्हाइल दीज फोर पिलर्स हैज सिक्स आउटकम एरियाज, दीज फोर पिलर्स हैव सिक्स आउटकम एरियाज विच आर हेल्थ एंड वेलबींग, न्यूट्रिशन एंड फूड सिक्योरिटी, क्वालिटी एजुकेशन, इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड डिसेंट वर्क, एनवायरमेंट क्लाइमेट वॉश एंड रेजिलियंस, एंड फाइनली एम्पावरिंग पीपल कम्युनिटीज एंड इंस्टीट्यूशंस. सो दीज आर द सिक्स आउटकम एरियाज ऑफ द फोर पिलर्स. ठीक है, आई होप दिस न्यूज इज क्लियर. एंड गाइज, इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, आई एम रिपीटिंग दिस. हेल्थ एंड वेलबींग इज देयर, न्यूट्रिशन एंड फूड सिक्योरिटी इज देयर, सस्टेनेबल फाइनेंस जैसा कुछ नहीं है, एनवायरमेंट क्लाइमेट वॉश एंड रेजिलियंस इज देयर, एंड क्वालिटी एजुकेशन इज देयर. तो 1, 2, 4, and 5 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन सी, ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. आई होप दिस न्यूज इज क्लियर. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 देन. Which ministry has unveiled Dugdh Sankalan Sathi mobile app? This, the answer would be very surprising for you, because looking at this word Dugdh, which means milk, you must be wondering that the ministry the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy, or it may be Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, but no. To your surprise, the ministry which has launched this mobile app is the Ministry of Heavy Industries, right? Alright, so correct answer मैंने आपको already बता दिया. It has been launched by Ministry of Heavy Industry. The name is Dugdh Sankalan Sathi Mobile App. Dugdh Sankalan Sathi Mobile App. Now, why this app has been launched? This app will digitize the process and facilitate direct benefit transfer to the milk producers, right? For digitizing the process and facilitate the direct benefit transfer to the milk producer. With that objective, this app has been launched. And of course, it will improve the quality of milk. It will promote transparency among the stakeholders in this area. Streamline operations at the grassroots village level, including milk cooperative society. Okay. It has been developed by, yes, this is very, very important. It has been designed and developed by Rajasthan Electronics and Instruments Limited. Rajasthan Electronics and Instruments Limited, which is located in Jaipur, and it is a mini Ratna under the Ministry of Heavy Industries. Alright. Aage chale. So these are some of the key features. Key features wahi hai jo ki iske objective mein the. So you guys can read it out from the PDF. Theek hai, aur ye sara word to word yaad rakhne ki aap logo ko bilkul bhi zarurat nahi hai. And therefore, what is the correct answer? Option E, Ministry of Heavy Industry. Question number 5. Consider the following statements with respect to the Gandhi Peace Prize, and you need to identify the incorrect statement. So the Gandhi Peace Prize for the year 2021 has been announced, and it has been conferred on Geeta Press. That's why Gandhi Peace Prize is in news. It has been conferred on Geeta Press, which is a very famous publication, house, right? And it generally publishes the religious books, right? The very famous is the Bhagavad Gita of this Geeta Press, right? सबसे ज़्यादा बिकने वाली किताब Geeta Press की. And in fact, Bhagavad Gita, जितनी भी बिक रही है हमारे देश में, all are, most of them are published by Geeta Press only. The best version is, they say, the best version is from the Geeta Press. मैंने तो पढ़ी नहीं है, but yes, लोग कहते हैं कि Geeta Press का version सबसे best है, and सबसे famous है. So, Geeta Press has been awarded the Gandhi Peace Prize. So now, talking about Gandhi Peace Prize. And remember, Geeta Press is located in Gorakhpur. Where is Gorakhpur? Gorakhpur is in Uttar Pradesh, of course. So Gandhi Peace Prize, it was initiated in the year 1995 on 125th birth anniversary of the great Mahatma Gandhi, right? And it was instituted as a tribute to the ideals espoused by Mr. Gandhi. It is given to institutions or individuals or organizations for their contribution towards social, economic and political upliftment of this society on the lines of Gandhian ideals, right? It is open to all persons regardless of their nationality, race, caste, of course, creed, kuch bhi nahi hai. Koi bhi status matter nahi karta yahan pe, right? 1 crore rupaye milte hai isme. It carries an amount of rupees 1 crore. 1 crore rupaye bahut hota hai award ke form mein. 1 crore rupaye milta hai, jo bhi awardee hota hai. The selection jury is very important. You can see the selection jury consists of the Prime Minister as well. The selection jury consists of Prime Minister of India, leader of opposition in Lok Sabha, chief justice of India, speaker of Lok Sabha, and one other eminent person. So you can see, you know, the very high profile people are there in the jury which selects the awardee, right? And recent awardees ki baat kare to 2020 it was conferred to Sheikh Mujibur Rahman from Bangladesh, 2019 Sultan Qaboos bin Syed Al Sayed from Oman, Yohei Sasakawa in the year 2018 from Japan, and Ekkal Abhyan Trust in the year 2017. Theek hai, so you can say nationality doesn't matter. Bangladesh se Sheikh Mujibur Rahman ko bhi mila tha. To nationality bhi, nationality ka status bhi nahi hai. It is open for everything, everyone, every category, right? That is all, and let's identify the incorrect statement. It is an annual award instituted by Government of India in 2000. No. It is open to all persons regardless of nationality, race, language. Bilkul sahi baat hai. It carries an amount of rupees 5 crores. No. It is given only to individuals. No. So incorrect, kitne ho gaye? 1, 3 and 4. Option D will be the correct answer. Now guys, please focus whether you have to identify the correct statement and incorrect or incorrect statement. मैं बार बार इस चीज को बोलता हूं, बिकॉज यू कैन सी इन द ऑप्शन देर इज टू ओनली एज वेल विच इज द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, बट यू नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, राइट? सो प्लीज फोकस ऑन दिस वर्ड. क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स द टर्म डेक्कन हाई लेवल प्रिंसिपल्स वॉज इन यूज रिसेंटली. इट इज रिलेटेड टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. सो दिस टर्म डेक्कन हाई लेवल प्रिंसिपल, इट इज नथिंग बट एन आउटकम ऑफ द G20 एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर्स मीटिंग विच took place recently in Hyderabad in Telangana, right? The four priorities of this meeting were the promotion of agriculture diversity and improvement of social security systems, financing climate friendly technologies for sustainable agriculture production, inclusive growth through a resilient agriculture, and digitization of agriculture sector. Now again, you don't have to remember this word to word, just focus on the keywords. Here the keyword is agriculture diversity, right? Here the keyword is financing climate friendly technologies. Okay, here resilient agriculture supply chain, and number four, digitization of agriculture sector. These were the four focus areas of this meeting. Now there are two major outcomes of this particular meeting. Number one is the Deccan high level principles. Now these principles demonstrate the G20 collective responsibility in response to the global food security crisis. All right, global food security crisis ke towards G20 ki kya collective responsibility hai, ye usko demonstrate karta hai. All right, it will facilitate humanitarian assistance to countries who are in need, to countries where there is a major issue of the hunger. It also seeks to strengthen food safety nets and access to nutritious food, right? So overall it is about the nutritious food, reducing the level of hunger, reducing the global food crisis, okay, food security crisis. And the second outcome is Maharishi. What is that? It is International Millets and Other Asian Grains Research Initiative, and as the name suggests, it is focused on advancing the research in the grains, especially millets, in this International Year of Millets and afterwards as well, okay. So for research in the Asian grains and millets. And remember one more thing guys, that Prime Minister Modi has proposed to include African Union as a member of G20, and if it will happen, this organization will become G21. But for this, जितने भी मेंबर नेशंस हैं उनकी जो है मंजूरी चाहिए होगी, तभी हो पाएगा ये. अभी उन्होंने प्रपोज किया है, ठीक है? सो दैट इज ऑल, एंड लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई दिस टर्म इज रिलेटेड टू फूड सिक्योरिटी एंड न्यूट्रिशन. वंस अगेन द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. विच ऑनलाइन एक्सचेंज फोरम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय BIS टू नर्चर स्टूडेंट एज ब्रांड एम्बेसडर्स ऑफ क्वालिटी. So remember, BIS has launched two things. Number one is Manak Rath, number two is Public Call Facility. Manak Rath has been launched, this initiative has been launched for nurturing students as brand ambassadors of quality. And for doing this, various quiz, competition, essay writing, ye sari cheez organize karai jayegi so that we can nurture students as the brand ambassadors of quality. Remember this, that it has been launched by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. And what is this public call facility? It will make the process of standardization more inclusive. And through this public call facility, the BIS will invite, you know, suggestions, feedbacks from the general public on how we can enhance the level of standardization in the country, right? And yeah, it will be open on all working days, 10 se 11 baje. That is not important for us. So for nurturing student as brand ambassadors, it is Manak Rath. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 8, which ministry or ministries in collaboration with Partnership for Maternal Newborn Child Health, which is located in Geneva, have organized G20 co-branded event titled Health of Youth, Wealth of Nation in New Delhi. Health of Youth, Wealth of Nation in New Delhi. कौन सी ministry या ministries ने मिलकर organize किया था? So remember, it was organized by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare only to highlight health and well-being needs of around 1.8 billion adolescents and youth worldwide and foster the increased attention and investment by G20 nation in health of the in health and adolescents of the youth. ठीक है जी. So basically it was for adolescent health, the youth health. उसके ऊपर कैसे focus करा जाएगा by the G20 member nation. It was all about that. Organizers were the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and you know, this was organized in partnership with PMNCH, which is located in Geneva. Now, what is this PMNCH? PMNCH, remember guys, it is the globe's largest alliance for women's, children's and adolescents' health and well-being, with more than 1250 partner organizations. It was established in the year 2005, and its headquarters, not headquarters, it is, you know, the secretariat is provided by the headquarters of WHO, World Health Organization, which is located in Geneva in Switzerland, right? So the correct answer will be Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, option A. Question number 9. But before moving ahead to the question number 9, guys, let me tell you this, that jo RBI 2010 se leke 2022 past year paper ki book launch ho chuki hai, right? You guys can purchase that book, theek hai, from the link provided in the description. Amazon pe bhi hai aur hamari website pe hai. Now the speciality of that book is that it contains why a particular question was asked in that particular exam. So the detailed explanations have been provided in the book, and definitely it is going to be a game changer for you all. Right, so to avail that book, you can visit the Amazon, you can visit our website as well. The link is provided in the description. Bahut hi important book hai aap logo ke liye. Which platform for young professionals engaged in various ministries, government departments and organizations has been made live on I Got Karma Yogi platform to enhance their knowledge, skills and abilities. Okay, so this platform is Dakshata. The platform is Dakshata, which stands for Development of Attitude, Knowledge, Development of Attitude, Knowledge, Skill for Holistic Transformation in Administration. Okay? For Holistic Transformation in Administration. Now this Dakshata, this is nothing. This platform will provide training, or it will enhance the capacity of the people who are working in the government organization. Right? It has been tailored for young professional and consultants engaged in government. And it consists of 18 courses which will build functional domain and behavioral competences by acquainting learners with subjects for discharging their duties and responsibility. So basically, in short, वही है जो मैंने पहले बताया कि this platform will provide training in all the domains to the government functionaries, and with that they'll be able to perform their roles and responsibilities effectively. Right? That is all. Now, I Got Karma Yogi platform. What is that? I Got, remember, stands for Integrated Government Online Training. It is a part of Karma Yogi, Mission Karma Yogi of the Government of India. It is a comprehensive online platform which guide government officials in their capacity building journey. And finally, it combines 6 functional hubs for online learning, for competency management, for career management, discussion, event, sari cheeze. And remember, दिस आई गॉट प्लेटफॉर्म इट इज बीइंग मैनेज बाय कर्मयोगी भारत, कर्मयोगी भारत विच इज अ गवर्नमेंट ओन नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट स्पेशल पर्पज व्हीकल. इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पर्सनल पब्लिक ग्रीवेंसेस एंड पेंशंस एंड इट इज इंटरेस्टेड विद रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ ओनिंग मैनेजिंग एंड डूइंग एवरीथिंग विद द आई गॉट मिशन कर्मयोगी प्लेटफॉर्म. ऑलराइट, तो ये था भाई एंड द करेक्ट आंसर इज दक्षता, ऑप्शन बी. And now let's move ahead to the questions in short, which do not need much explanation. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this class, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. And that book, do not forget to buy. Wo book bahut aapko help karegi. Question number 10. As per data released by the Finance Ministry, net direct tax collections have grown to dash and gross direct tax collection have grown to dash till June 17, 2023 in the financial year 23-24. Now, generally, I do not provide the monthly data and such data, but since the exam is near and I just do not trust the examiner these days. So, kuch bhi pooch rahe hai wo, so they can ask this also. So, the net direct tax collections have increased to 379,760 crores and gross direct tax collections have increased to 419,338 crores. Option B is the correct answer. Alright, option B is the correct answer. Question number 11. Whereas the free telemedicine startup mobile camp Doctor on Wheels been inaugurated to overcome the problems of accessibility, availability and affordability. Right. It was organized in Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir at a place called Bilawar. And Bilawar may be a block hai Mandli. In that block this was organized and therefore the correct answer is option C. Question number 12. Which state has signed an MOU with NHPC Limited for accelerated development of its hydroelectric potential in the most techno-commercially viable manner and for clean energy transition? This MOU has been signed between NHPC Limited and Kerala State Electricity Corporation and therefore the correct answer is option D. Question number animated film on National Water Mission's mascot has been released recently during the 4th National Water Awards ceremony. What is the name of the mascot of the mission? Very important question. Chacha Chaudhary ko jab mascot banaya gaya tha Namami Gange Mission ka, that time the question was asked in RBI. This time National Water Mission ka jo mascot hai wo news mein hai, so they can ask you this question. The correct answer is Piku. Right, option E, Piku is the correct answer. India has become the dash largest producer of scientific research after overtaking UK in 2022. So remember, India is now the third largest producer of scientific research after USA and China. Right? USA and China. So the correct answer is option C, third largest. Question number 15. Government of India in consultation with RBI has opened SGB 2324 series 1. ओके, तो ये हमने अभी रिसेंटली डिस्कस किया था आई बिलीव प्रीवियस क्लास में ही. तो नाउ इश्यू प्राइस भी पढ़ लो, चलो कुछ सब कुछ पढ़ लो. एग्जामिनर को मौका मत दो कि वो तुम्हें तुमसे आगे निकल जाए, एक कदम आगे चलो. राइट, तो द इश्यू प्राइस ऑफ द बॉन्ड ड्यूरिंग द सब्सक्रिप्शन पीरियड विल बी रुपीज 5926. ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 16. एट विच आईआईटी हैज एनटीपीसी विद्युत व्यापार निगम लिमिटेड कमीशन 1 मेगावाट रूफटॉप सोलर पावर प्रोजेक्ट? कौन सी आईआईटी पे किया है? एनटीपीसी विद्युत व्यापार निगम लिमिटेड ने. द करेक्ट आंसर इज आईआईटी जोधपुर. एंड वेयर इज जोधपुर? राजस्थान. ऑप्शन बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 17. अंडर स्कीम ऑफ असिस्टेंस टू नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स फेडरेशन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यूथ अफेयर्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स हैज रिवाइज द अपर सीलिंग अमाउंट ऑफ बोर्डिंग एंड लॉजिंग फॉर इंडियन एथलीट्स एंड टीम ऑफिशियल्स बाय 66%. Under the newly revised norm, athletes and support staff traveling for approved competitions abroad will now be entitled to $250 per day. Right? $250. Earlier it was $150. From now they will be entitled to $250 per day and therefore the correct answer is option B. Question number 18. Ministry of Tourism in collaboration with which organization has developed G20 Tourism and SDG Dashboard? Very important question. To create a legacy from India's G20 presidency, by harnessing the potential of tourism in achieving the SDGs. ठीक है, तो this organization in question is United Nation WTO, not trade organization but tourism organization. ठीक है, United Nation World Tourism Organization which is headquartered in Madrid. And where is Madrid? Spain. Question number 19. Who has led the national celebration of International Day of Yoga with motto Yoga for Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam? So Prime Minister Modi जो है वो US में है, so every year वही lead करते हैं, but this time it was led by Vice President of India who was the chief guest during the International Day of Yoga, the major event. However, Prime Minister ने United Nation के office में lead किया है International Day of Yoga को. How many new workers have been added under ESIC in the month of April 2023? 17.88 lakh. Very important question. And guys, the last question for today. How many projects worth 1,13,285 crores have been sanctioned under Sagarmala project in Maharashtra only? The question is regarding Maharashtra only. So 126 projects. Option C is the correct answer. Alright guys, so that is all for today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And I will see you in the next class tomorrow. Till then, keep studying and keep studying hard. Goodbye, take care and God bless.